Good evening, ma'am. So my topic for this video presentation is bad loans in India. So coming to the definition, defaulting on loans happens when repayments aren't made for a certain period of time. When that happens, that particular loan can be classified as a bad loan or a non-performing asset. So coming to the extent of the problem, in the past 5 years, the pool of small borrowers has almost doubled compared to the previous 5 years, that is to 58 million. According to MFIN, there is one member in every 20 Indians with a debt. So in total, they owe about $31.6 billion. So India's biggest 2,426 members had a debt of around 1.47 lakhs crores, which is a huge amount. People like Vijay Mallya, Mehul Chosky, and Nirav Modi are among the biggest defaulters in India so far. So coming to the implications of the problem, if you look at here, this is the non-performing loans ratio. It's the ratio between the amount of non-performing asset divided by the actual amount, that is actual debt that is there in the economy. So if we if you look at the figures from 2010 to 2012, it was constant. From 2012, it has started increasing, and it has rocketed up from 2015. This is probably due to various new policies that has been taken up by the government. When there are new policies, usually there will be a certain backdrop. If you look at 2016, at that point of time, demonetization occurred, and in 2017 there is introduction of GST. So due to various new policies taken up by the government, it has rocketed up. And it has reached its peak on by 2018. After 2018, due to various policies taken up by the government, like Indian Bankruptcy Code, which was introduced in 2016, the number has started to come down. But after the advent of COVID, I think the number is going will go up in 2021 again. So if you look at the right side graph, the NPA write-off is actually is more compared to the recovery rate. So we can clearly this actually creates a huge deficit between the both, which is not at all good for the economy. So coming to the reasons, the first one is crony capitalism, which is common in almost every single country. The second reason I would like to talk about is the euphoria between 2004 and 2011. During this point of time, the economy is in a boom, and people started borrowing more than they should have. So that has actually started creating a problem. So projects that are being taken up by these people have stopped due to various reasons. Let's say if a steel company owner took a loan for and after that after a certain point of time the value of steel has come down, that has forced him to abandon that particular project. So this has actually created a huge deficit, and the money is sometimes being siphoned off, and some cases, as I discussed before, become stagnant due to various incomplete projects taken up by the people. So coming to the solutions and minimizing impact, the first one I would like to talk about is Indian Bankruptcy Code. The Indian Bankruptcy Code need to be more agile in clearing out the problems. Right now, it has it is concentrating on the bigger NPAs, but the number of the amount involved in the with the smaller companies is huge, and the number of companies are also huge. So IBC needs to go to the individual level in clearing out the problems, the NPAs with the smaller companies. Second one I would like to talk about is more alert depositors. Government need to encourage people to deposit their amount in different banks so that they can diversify their risk when such crisis happens. So government needs to come up with a new website or a new platform so that people can compare two particular banks and decide on where to deposit. So next one I would like to talk about is creation of a liquid market for NPA via online. So online system needs to be encouraged here so that the banks can banks can sell the non-performing assets through via online. There is a more chance for transparency and a better price discovery. And fourth one I would like to talk about is a reduction in government stake in banks. Right now, most of the banks are confident because the amount of stake government has in the banks, they're confident that government can take care when the crisis happens. So when if there is a reduction in the government stake, the bank particular banks will be more vigilant in giving out loans. They will be more careful in checking the credit score of a particular company or a particular person in an individual level. So this is what I would like to talk about. Thank you so much.